for more?
Hello. So this is the seventh guest, which came out in 93. And I played it probably in 96 or 97. I don't think I made it to the end, but I made it through most of the game. It was the seventh guest, obviously, back then. And then there was the sequel of the 11th Hour. And this version is actually the 25th Anniversary Edition, which should be pretty similar, if not the same. I don't know what the differences are, but it's the 25th Anniversary Edition. And basically, we're just going to run through all the puzzles and do pretty much a complete walkthrough of the entire game, which shouldn't take that long because there's not that many puzzles. I'm guessing probably a couple hours. Let's start. And this game, from what I recall, has a lot of videos, I guess. A lot of cutscenes that it goes through. Not very good. Okay. Skip through the credits.
He was a drifter, moving from town to town, robbing a gas station here, a grocery store there, until one night. She was coming home from choir practice, but she never got there. Stoff took her purse and ran away. The pittance spent, Stoff had to run and hide. He sunk even more. He had nothing. No life, no possessions, no dreams.
I figured with the 25th Anniversary Edition, they would have cleaned this up a little bit, but clearly they did not. It's still...
Stoff carved the doll, twittering the haunting face, until it was an exact replica. And when he was done... Stoff went to town, to a bar. The owner had a daughter. Ooh, he said his girl would love the strange doll. And Stoff offered it to the man. And the owner, in turn, offered Stoff food and a place to stay. A simple transaction. The first of many.
Skip through this.
Stop. And we'll just another keep on the vision.
Narration and everything in here.
Stoff created the puzzle just as he saw it. And everyone wanted one.
So basically the short version is you end up in this mansion.
Stoff opened up a shop because everyone wanted a Stoff toy. Every boy and girl in the town,
full of puzzles.
From all the neighboring
towns. The whole point of the game is just
a stomp toy is a toy for life.
Walk through the entire house.
No two are alike. Everyone loved his unique toys. Henry Stoff grew wealthy, but then the strange virus came, and some of the children started dying.
I just don't recall if I made it to the very end of this thing or not.
Dying, clutching their stock toys so close.
So this was one of the very first computer games that I bought. I don't think it was the first one, but one of the first ones that I bought. And then I also remember buying the 11th Hour, which is
and there was this one last vision.
And I didn't get far on that one at all.
Of a great house, a mansion that the wealthy toy maker was to build. A strange house. A house that scared.
It's a cheery place. Edward, I'm not sure we should have been here today.
Why? Because it's a spooky old house? Don't worry, dear. I'll watch out for you.
First, we want to go here to the dining room.
Okay, we're gonna do the cake puzzles. Go through the double doors on the left into the dining room.
So basically, you're just clicking around. You move the mouse to the center. It tells you if you want to go there. You move it either left or right. I don't think there's up and down. Unless you go up the stairs. So basically, you're just walking through the house until you find puzzles, and you don't know where the puzzles are, so I can go left, I can go right, I can go straight. You don't know where the puzzles are until you see the little brain thing. Or another cutscene.
I guess our host wants us to fend for ourselves.
Oh, I've tasted better fare.
At least he left his regrets.
I'll show you mine. You show me yours.
I don't know.
Oh, it says that we're each to have a piece. Exactly the same, including the symbols. But that's impossible.
Okay, so you get a little cutscene, give you some clues, and then you get one of these little skull brain things, and that tells you that it's a puzzle. I think the chatter thing replays the video to get the clues. Or you can leave.
No, we want to click on the cake.
Yeah. Ah! Become a grave digger now, have we? You are a glutton, punishment.
So this one you're supposed to get two of the grave pieces and two of the skulls and one empty piece. So you're supposed to select five pieces until you match up enough that it finishes the whole cake, if that makes sense. So we'll just go through this.
Two skulls and two stones. The rest is just icing.
So select two stones, two skulls.
Some cannot be created more equal than others.
Basically, you would just keep trying it out until you matched up enough and it ended out equally, I guess, is really what you're supposed to do. Basically just keep trying until it either failed and you'd have to start over, or you would match them all up.
Don't worry, I won't bite. Edward, we could help each other out. I could help you, and you could help me.
I smell her perfume.
Come and talk in my bedroom upstairs, where it's nice and private.
Isn't.
So it looks like everybody in the house is trying to go around and solve the puzzles too. I just don't know what the point was of what solving all the puzzles did.
Well, we'll find out at the end, maybe. Alright, so we need to swap cans around to form a valid sentence.
Here's food for thought. Be warned, though. Your mind will be gorged before this night is done.
Maybe you thought So first word is shy, S-H-Y.
There's more to these cans than meets the eye.
Other than writing down all the letters and trying to see what word you come up with this, I don't know how in the world you...
This would get really tricky.
Because that's quite a few different possibilities.
Yeah.
I don't think you can do this.
Back before you could find anything online.
Yes.
That would be so hard to figure out without
this. I don't know.
There. Now I've solved it.
So am I just invisible?
Apparently. She put them all back. Oh, I should probably tell you what she did. So now we're going to do the next one, which is the telescope puzzle. So go back out of the kitchen to the lobby. Just straight back through there. We just went straight, so...
I just remember this game being very, very long. Just trying to navigate through this thing and then trying to figure these puzzles out.
From the lobby, go to the other side and through the single door into the library.
I think that's a puzzle there.
Yeah. across to the other side of the room and examine the telescope. Click on the letters to form a valid sentence.
You'll need more than lenses to focus your thoughts on this one.
So this sentence, there, T-H-E-R-E.
Now this doesn't make sense, or does it? Perplexing planetary poser. How puzzling. Perhaps a phonemic path can be phrased with a little postulation.
I don't think so.
Now this doesn't make sense. Or does it? Perplexing planetary poser. How puzzling. Perhaps a phonemic path can be phrased with a little postulation.
Having fun yet, mortal?
What twisted crime of logic would merit such a sentence?
This one being hard enough as it was, but the 11th hour, I know it was. Anyway, the 11th hour, I know I didn't get far in that game, but I played it a little bit, and I know that was plenty hard as it was.
Did you even map? Go upstairs.
don't remember how far I got into that.
And to the left, or turn left, enter the first room on the left. That's right.
We'll skip that, whatever that was.
Okay.
Do you need chasing the kid? Okay, what did you say? First door on the left?
First room on the left. My left.
Oh, this is all so beautiful. Look at this bed. Just like the bed I used to have.
Well, so they're already quite lived. They just each got their own room.
Look at the bedspread.
And then start off into space. Look at the bedspread.
Yeah. I don't know how you're supposed to look at it. Click on the letters. So, something's on the bedspread. You gotta somehow figure out how to get there. Left up the stairs, right? Up the stairs and to the left?
Yeah.
My left?
Yeah, my left.
There it is. That's not the bedspread, but okay.
The carpet? Carpet, not the bedspread.
This plumbing could get you into hot water.
I know where I am now, but I was thinking.
Because there's the stairs. Yeah, here we go. So follow the ghost girl, but go into the first door on the left. Other one.
Skipping threes and skipping fives, perhaps that's how one derives the answer to this wordy tale. But you won't win. You're bound to fail.
Yeah, I think this one's
hard. Click on the letters starting from the arrow. Going forward or backward, 5 spaces. The sky, the star, sky, star, is star, red, star, your star, fate, is star, flame.
There are stars in space, but no spaces are allowed here. Only stars.
Yeah, so these are used as the space.
What did Stoff mean by threes and fives?
Backwards three.
I can't just step anywhere.
Backwards three. Sky.
S. This is an I right here.
So click the one up, isn't it?
Right, but I can't click on that one. It's not three or five. So it's this I. And then back five. To
oh,
this.
I see. Okay.
And then space.
And that's on I, doesn't help. But yeah,
do
space. Next word is bloody. The B.
It's an R.
It's a B. Well, I thought that was an I, and that's an L.
Think you'll be so lucky next time.
Sky is bloody.
I don't know. Your face is bloody.
It rhymes, but I don't
know. Yeah.
You know the others will try to beat us. But it doesn't have to be that way. Not if you and I work together. We can solve Stump's puzzle. We can win. You can get what you want, Edward. What is it that you want, Edward? Shall I try to guess? I know where the puzzles are to be solved. I know where the puzzles are. I'll take you there. But first...
The perfume. The smell. It's changing. I can't breathe. I feel so sick.
I will give you everything. I will give you what you want.
So, turn around and leave the room and enter the room directly across the corridor.
A maze. I remember doing something like this when I was a little girl. You have to follow it all the way to the center.
Just look at the rug on the floor and make a note of it. There's a map for later in the game. know. Click on the rug again to see a grid.
Don't you just love surprises?
Make the list of moves as follows.
Oh, there's one over there. Can you?
So it's A1, A2.
So
B, C, D, and E.
One, two, three, four.
Okay, so you try and just read it to me and I'll see if I can.
A2 to B3.
Down. Oh, that automatically moves it. Okay.
E2 to B3.
E2.
Okay. D3 goes to B1. The one that you just moved, the white one,
will
go to B1.
Which way should I go now?
Down to B1. Right
there.
Here. Yeah.
Which way should I go now?
To C4.
Which way should I go now? I'm going to have to start again.
Okay, so that resets it.
Okay, so yeah.
So this little time clock thing resets it. This gives us a blue sort of, I guess.
Which way should I go now?
B3.
Which way should I go now?
Did we do that? We didn't do that.
Yeah.
No, I didn't put one down there.
Oh, we skip that one then? Yeah. So that's probably why I didn't go.
Yeah.
Okay.
So B3 to D1 I just did. So you skip one.
E4 to D3.
C4. Which way should I go now?
Okay.
B1 to A2.
Which way should I go now?
D1 to C2.
Okay.
C2 to E4.
Which way should I go now?
Apparently you can't move in certain spots of pieces.
C4 to E2.
C4 to E2.
Should I go now?
B1.
Yeah. A4 to C2. C2, E4.
Which way should I go now?
To E4?
Yep. B2 to D1.
E2.
C4 to B3.
C4.
Which way should I go now?
B3. B3 to A4.
Which way should I go now?
B1 to B3.
Which way should I go now? Should I go now?
D3, E2.
Yeah.
A3, B2.
Yeah.
E3, B2.
Yeah.
E2, B4.
Which way should I go now?
To B4.
B4. B2, B4.
Which way should I go now?
E1, D2.
Which way should I go now?
B4 to A3.
Which way should I go now?
B4 to C3. C3 to E1.
Which way should I go now? Which way should I go now?
This makes no sense whatsoever.
A1 to C3.
Okay.
C3 to E1.
Which way should I go now?
E3, B4.
Which way should I go now?
To B2.
Which way should I go now?
B4, D2.
Which way should I go now?
D2.
D4 to B2. And I'll let you figure out the rest.
I have no idea.
B2.
Which way should I go now?
I thought you were being serious.
No!
Oh! I should have not let you figure out the rest. You got them backwards. My fault. I didn't realize that. We have to do it again. Because you should have done B2 to A3 first, and then B2 to E3.
Why?
That's what I was supposed to do.
Yeah, but we finished the puzzle.
Yeah, but we didn't do it this way.
I don't know. Whatever.
Okay, let's do it again. We got this now.
I'm not doing it again.
We didn't finish it, though.
Yeah, we did.
Is it, does it say completed on the map?
I don't want to get sent back to the beginning, but... Yeah, we saw both of those.
But he said no.
Yeah, because we solved it.
Oh, so he meant no as in we solved it, not no as in we didn't solve it.
Yeah.
Okay. So I was about to not let you solve any more of these on your own.
Okay, so we didn't go back to the beginning.
Okay, so... Okay, so let's go on to the next one, the blood flow. So go back out to the hallway.
Which is the last one that I found, right?
I think so. Go. Where's the door? Oh, right there.
That's the door. That's.
That's a mirror.
Hmm.
Oh, that's interesting. Turn left. Walk past the staircase. And through the door on the left.
Should have just done that one.
We could have. I mean, we could have, but. Look at the rug on the floor. Open and close the small gates.
This plumbing could get you into hot water.
So we have to connect the heart with the far end of the maze. It's easiest to work backward from the end. So click on the heart to start the blood flow.
You started? Okay.
I don't know.
Why would you work backwards?
Well, I don't think you start the heart.
No, I'm like, that doesn't make any sense.
Let's restart.
This is trickier than it looks.
Don't do the heart until we get it fixed. Oh, shush. You didn't know left from right.
Okay. You said work back, and you said turn on the heart. I'm like, what doesn't make sense?
He just read the whole thing. It says click on the heart.
Okay. So.
Open and close the small gates on the pathway. Connect the
There's something not quite straightforward about this maze.
So I can see how to do it.
Okay.
So open that one.
This one?
No.
I just did.
No, that one.
You shouldn't have turned down here.
Open. Wait. There's two ways. Okay, yeah, go up. Open that one.
Oh. Bad.
One. Hang on a second. Well, I see two ways that we could do this, but I'm not paying attention to what they do. So, if we're going up.
If you fall here.
You can go down or up.
Go. So this would have to get turned to go down this way.
And then you want to open that one. And then open that one. But then close. Oh.
So you'd go.
Well, if you do that, it'll slow.
That stops, like, so you can't go that way.
Well, no, but from where you're at, it'll go down. Under, under, under. So you want to close that one. Go, open that one. Go, open that one. Or close it, yeah. Close. Nope, that's not it.
So you open that one, it goes that way. You come down here. From what I recall, you go it goes through like most of the thing.
Does it?
Yeah.
Okay, so if we open
down first.
We go down. Open that one. Open. No. Because they're not doing what I want them to do.
Okay. So go down. Under there.
That's not gonna work.
Yeah, I could have swore you like went through the entire
There's nothing.
Thing. To go that way.
Open that one.
Then open that one. That one has to be open.
Open.
That way. This one has
that
to be
one.
Open. That has to be open.
And then open.
That one has to be
That's
open.
That's closed. Open that one. No.
It's going to go back down this way.
Well, it won't even go up right there. Those two are closed.
It's going to go this way. Down here.
But it. Blood can't get up right there.
Okay. Follow this, so that goes up there. Goes that way. So where are you saying it can't go from? So now we're here.
Yeah,
it's gone. So it goes down. So then either that's gotta go straight.
Have to.
That goes that way.
No, that won't work.
That way.
Oh, I see. It goes
that
under.
Goes that way. There.
Okay. Try it.
That's a bad.
That graphics.
I guess it was good for the 90s. Yeah, so I remember going through like the entire thing almost. So
that's
speedy. Speedy, this is not. So working backwards is a lot easier.
Yeah.
And there's just only so many ways you can go.
I want them to flip the other way sometimes and they won't.
No.
You could be a cardiologist.
Yes.
We have blood all over the
cover. Right. Who's going to pick that up? Okay. Is there any little pressing?
Wait! Come back! Don't! You have to leave, son. You have to come with me.
Why should I trust you?
Trust him. Don't trust him.
Please, come back before.
Turn around. This room.
I guess that's where this blood on the floor.
Turn left and go through another door into the games room. That's left, yes. Go into the games room. Click on the chessboard.
The madman's playroom.
Didn't he just get strangled?
That's what I thought.
Tell me, madman, can you give me real magic? Can you show me?
That was like a clue to do the chessboard.
Yeah.
A queen is lethal.
Queens can go anywhere they want, as long as it's in a straight line.
Oh, so basically you're putting the queens so they can't hurt each other.
Put one there. I'm gonna put one. If you go to the...
Eight queens. Each must be out of touch with all the others.
So you initially didn't know how many you were supposed to put, but it's like eight of them can't ever hit each other.
No! They want the boy!
Shouldn't be here.
No! Curse you! You can't! Hey, who are you?
I just want to get out of here. Please! I just want to get out of here.
Who are you? Why did you come here? Wait! Wait! I know who you are! I know who you are! You're the seventh guest! And what I just saw! Now I understand! Oh, sweet mercy, I understand!
Mister, I'm sorry! I just came here! They dared me!
The king? You? You're the one!
I'm gonna leave it!
Don't run away, please! Don't run away! Don't go! Don't go! No! Don't go!
Stop. Don't run.
Well, not as out of order. Well, I don't
know. Well, because wasn't he the one who got strangled in the other room and, like, he was saying, like, trust me, Jake?
Yeah. So.
I don't know.
Doesn't mean he died, but I guess he could have.
Well, but then we saw him running down and into the room. I think the scenes are just off on this.
Yeah.
Okay, so moving on.
So, if he thinks the kid is the seventh guest, then who am I supposed to be?
Or a ghost.
Apparently. Oh. Because okay. Nobody can see me.
We're standing right there. We just watched that, so I don't know. Okay, click on the billiard table to go through a secret passage down into the kitchen. They weren't guests. We're like seriously just going through an oven. We're a ghost. Turn right and go through the single door.
Cause I don't think there's any particular order we have to solve these in.
Probably not.
Oh, I'm dying. to see what you do next.
Yeah, circles you move through. I just don't remember.
So you need to rearrange the gate so you can get through a hole on the right side. Click on them in this order. 5.
Well, I don't know what the numbers are. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so start at the top. 1, this is 2, this is 3, 5, and 6.
Might be handy to know that, right?
Click on 5. Okay.
Pat, I'll take. What is knowledge?
Show me potato salad.
Alright, so did you click 5?
So 5.
Finding things a little grating.
These puns are just not funny. 6.
Yeah, this one was a 2.
Nothing ever seemed to slide into place in this place.
Get him in the right spot.
2.
If I plan to get around this grate, I'll need to get around.
5. 4. 1. 2. 5. 6. 3. 2.
Because you can fit through a hole, but you can't fit through that.
Yeah.
2.
2. 5. 4. 1. There's a big hole right there. 2. 3, 6, 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 6, 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 6, 5.
So even open that up just kills me.
Great move. I have a bad feeling about this.
Oh my gosh.
How does it feel to be the first living thing to set foot in these dungeons in? I can't remember how long.
I guess I didn't need to count because the skeleton would be there.
Yeah. So you pretty much go until you get to the end.
Yeah. Then turn right and you'll hit a dead end.
Feeling lonely.
So turn left 3 times.
Okay, so that's...
So 1... Two. 3.
So this doesn't make sense because we could have just turned there when we got to that spot.
I don't know. I mean, obviously, yeah.
So if we went 9 times and then turned right.
Then go forward.
So that makes no sense.
Right 3 times. 1. 2 was going to say. Three.
So right three times.
Yeah. Left.
So that first part didn't make sense. You could have gotten by and then
right.
Instead of going down.
You shouldn't have turned down here.
You now need to close all the coffins at the same time. Clicking on one also affects the adjacent coffins, but the starting position is random, so a specific solution is not possible.
Don't think you'll be so lucky next time. Clearly. Shut the case.
So, do you know how to do it?
I don't remember.
So, clicking on one sets off the adjacent one. So, there has. But
yeah, so if I click on this one, it opens those.
Yeah.
So, what?
There's no pattern.
Oh, let's go on that. So now, I need to close all the coffins at the same time.
I'll help you. If you close the back corner one, it'll open this one and close that. And then you can close that, and it should close those two and that one. Right?
Sure. Then I also wanted to give credit to walkthroughking.com. That's where we're getting this walkthrough from. There's probably other ones online, but this is the one that I grabbed. Just walk this.
So,
okay, so
try that back corner one.
So this one should close that and open that one.
Well, but try the back.
This one?
Yeah. That back corner one? Okay. Oh,
an open and shut case. Or casket, perhaps.
Yeah, I really don't remember what to do this one.
Well, we could have done the one in the middle, but it would have opened those. So, then this one?
Yeah, you try to do it.
Okay.
I just don't remember.
Finding things a little cryptic.
The four winds change at every turn.
Close. Closed.
Closed.
Open.
Oh, you want me? So,
yes.
Close, open, open.
Open.
And then what one? Down. Back here.
Yes.
Open. Close. Open. Close, close, close.
No respect for the dead here. I should let sleeping bones lie.
Oh, my bad. Can I do it now? That was my idea the first time, it just didn't work.
So I went to Game Solutions.
Come with us now!
Let me go!
It's all right, sir. You're okay. Don't worry. She... It's just an illusion. An illusion. An illusion. An illusion. An illusion.
Okay.
Is it done?
I don't know. Yeah?
Okay, so I went to gamesolution.efzevn.nl. And you basically just type in the order that the coffins are open or closed from top to right, or left to right, top to bottom. You punch in closed or open, and hit solve, and that tells you which ones are open or closed, and that clearly worked. The other site that we were on just said it's random, and you just have to figure it out. So...
Alright, where do I go now?
Hold on. Yeah, the original site that we were, the original walkthrough that we were using says, so a specific solution is not possible because it's random. But we found, or I found another site that you basically punch in what's open and what closed, and it tells you how to fix it. So
I'm going to enter the nearest coffin to return through a secret passage to the kitchen.
Okay.
Weird how there's these secret passages that only ghosts could go through.
Yeah.
Return to the lobby and across to the other single door into the library again. I love libraries. I want a house with a library.
Back to the other side.
Yep. Back into the lab.
Singing upstairs, like some mad choir.
Well, I heard nothing except you rummaging around your room, yelling like a crazy man.
And I, I saw blood.
Oh, yes.
I don't know how to describe what I saw. Why, none of you has ever seen
it. None of the rest of us saw anything. How boring. I suggest we all leave and have some supper.
I think that we were meant to eat the soup.
Wait! Wait, we need some rules. We need to stick together, play as a team. Oh.
Don't be such a bore, darling.
It's a game. That's why we're invited. It's a game. Everyone for himself. Herself. Crazy old Stomp is watching us, scaring us, watching us play at his puzzles. Only he knows the rules. Only Stomp knows the rules.
And the audio and video seem to be a little off.
Yeah.
How many times is this crash?
Alright, microphone. Enter. Oh, that's where it is. Enter the fireplace to find another secret passage that takes you upstairs.
Straight through the fireplace somehow takes you upstairs?
Yeah.
Okay.
Go forward, then turn left.
That makes sense.
Go forward 4 times.
I'm probably
dead. I don't know.
So why couldn't we have just gone upstairs through the steps?
I don't know. Secret passages are cool. Two. Three.
There's the stairs.
Four. Turn right.
This person's directions are interesting.
Go through the door to another bedroom.
Because to me, it would have seemed like if we went through the fireplace, there would have been a reason.
Yeah.
Instead of just walking up the stairs.
Look at the near bedside table on the right. We're going to play the cards puzzle.
Oh, I'm dying to see what you will do next. Up and down and side to side. That's the way the cards unhide.
Click on the cards in the order shown for the two separate patterns to turn them over. So this is...
Well,
there's two ones.
Oh, so let's do this one first.
Okay.
So...
One, two, three.
A leap of intuition in order to unhide them.
One,
two, three.
Two, three. Oh, there.
Four is down. Five is down. Six. Seven. Eight is up. 9 is to your left, 10 is down, 11 is over the right, 12 is up, 13 is in the middle, 14 is up top.
Yes.
Okay, so you just need to flip them over in order, which will just take time flipping each one to figure out what numbers are which.
That one's 1. 2 is the middle right there. 3 is down 1, 4 is right there, 5 is up, 6 is over, 7 is up, 8 is going over, 9 is straight down, 10, 11, 12, 13,
again! Oh, so what does the DA stand for?
I don't know.
sturdy work. Even Houdini didn't use such heavy weight. Ah, perhaps this is the secret of Stomp's power. Yes!
Hello? What's the noise?
Yes!
Temple, what the hell are you doing? Stop it! Stop with your... No! Stop!
I'm so confused.
He tried to summon a lady and then turned into a skeleton.
Alright.
Alright.
Knight's puzzle. Turn around and leave this room through the middle door. Oh, that would get confusing.
What door did we come in? This one?
I don't have any clue. But we're going through the middle one now.
Nice.
Turn left. Go forward two times.
Where did we come in the middle? So where does the left and right door go?
I have no idea. So one.
Must be your room.
But I don't want to go in yet. I'm still a little shaky.
There's nothing to be scared of, except Stoff's tricks.
Will you be in your room?
Yes. Or the game.
We all want something, don't we? I mean, that's what we're here for, isn't it?
I suppose so.
And what is it that you want?
Oh, but what? Just... I've been a stage magician all my life. I want to know, is there real magic? Does Stoff know that? Can Stoff give that to me?
We need to find a way out. We need to start our life over again. I mean, Edward has gotten us into such debt, and there's no money. What about the others?
I don't
know. You're playing demon dog monster.
Sounds great.
Okay, so we went ahead once.
So then this will be number two. Then turn right and enter the bedroom. Should be where we did the bishop's puzzle. Cross the room and go through the other door into a bathroom.
I want to look at this maze again.
Yeah, I don't know where we were. Turn around and examine the floor to see a grid.
Turn around?
Yeah. Doesn't say what direction, so just turn around. On the floor, there's a grid.
Make your move.
Oh gosh, these are
if you dare.
So we have A, B, C, D, E. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just like last time, but it goes up 5 now.
A, B, C, D, E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so move the knights at these locations to swap their positions.
Knight.
A2.
A2.
Don't take all night.
Well, let us play. C1.
So that's how they move.
I don't know, I've never played chess before.
B3.
Black is white, and white is black. Everything must change.
Okay.
A1. C2. E3. D5.
Don't take all night.
B4. C2. A3.
Yeah, thinking back on playing this,
C4.
How in the world I saw these things were just a lot of trial and error. C4.
E5.
Don't take all night.
Oh, that took forever to play these games. E5?
Yep. D3? C5? E4?
Take all night.
B5.
There has to be more than one way to solve this, because I don't.
D4. C2. Maybe, but...
Well, I mean, because most of this is only one or two.
E1.
E1?
Well, knights can only move in L.
Yeah, so, I mean, you can only have a couple that would move there. So there's got to be more than one way to probably solve this one, but...
Don't take all night!
D3?
Okay, that's gonna be
good. I don't know.
D3?
C1?
C1?
C1? B3? A5? C4? A3? C2.
Don't take all night.
C2?
Yep. E3. C4. E5. D3. We have like 20 more moves. B2. A4.
Don't take all night.
You keep slowing down. You say that.
C5. B3. D2. E4. C5. B3. D2.
Don't take all night.
D2.
D2. B3. B1, C3. E2. D4. B3. D2. E4. C3.
Don't take all night.
Anytime I say C3, I want to say PO.
C3.
PO. D1. E3. D5. C3.
Don't take all night.
Oh my gosh, shush, man. D1. B2. A4. C5. E4.
Don't take all night.
We have like 30 more to go. C3. Turn right. Go forward. Enter the door on the left. Look at the case on the bed. That's a great bed.
Oh, I'm dying to see what you'll do next.
There. So that's another one of these pattern things. So, one, click, two, straight down, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Okay, so you're just turning over all the numbers in order that's following the path. So that wouldn't take too long to figure out. You just flip them over to eventually figure out.
Like a memory game.
Curses!
Figure out which number is where.
up and down and side to side.
This is like the weird deep one.
So go up two right there. Yep. So one, two, three, up one, four.
A leap of intuition to unhide them in sequential order.
Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. 20.
20.
So you live to play another day.
So does that mean you die if you don't get a puzzle right?
I don't know.
Certainly not a ghost.
Who's that? But he had a cane.
He did.
Oh my word. Yes. Oh, this is it? All this money. Rich. Filthy rich. No. What is this? What? What's going on?
I'm melting.
Need to see what's going on.
No. We lived to see another day, not him.
So we solved the puzzle. He clearly solved and got the case, but then...
then died.
Died.
We lived. He died.
This is so confusing.
Yeah. Turn around and go back through the door.
So are you each one of these people that solves it and then just dies, or?
Maybe. But no, because we're the seventh guest.
Well, I thought they were saying the kid was. Or he, well, I guess he thought the kid was
the seventh. They thought
guest.
The kid was a king. I don't.
A king?
Yeah. Because when we did the queen thing, Houdini guy was like, you're the king?
Oh, I missed that then.
Yeah. Turn around and go back through the door. Turn right. Go forward. Enter the door on the left to return to the bathroom.
Fine.
Go to the bathroom. Go down through the secret passage in the sink to return to the library.
Why not?
Oh, they were a ghost? I swear we're a ghost. No real person could fit through this.
Well, she clearly went through the...
yeah.
Black gloves all through the sink.
Yeah. I hate spiders. Guess what puzzle we're doing next? Spider puzzle. So, go out. Okay. Go out to the lobby and view the cutscene of the front door.
My dear Mr. Duttle, welcome to my house. The arrangement is simple. You are to spend the night as my guest, and in exchange, I will give you your heart's most secret desire. And you know what
Mr. Duttonbolt. I require one thing of you, a special service, a task that I've set up for you.
There's a guest who hasn't arrived yet. A guest unlike the six of you, a very special guest. Your services involve that guest. You must wonder what that service is, but that is the game, Mr. Dutton. The puzzle I've set for you. This is all I can tell you, Mr. Dutton. In the morning, only one of my guests will walk out of this house with his or her every wish granted.
But that's a cutscene that we could have seen at the very beginning when we started this, so I kind of wonder if we're in the right order.
So you need to place a spider and make it follow a straight line to another point. To solve the puzzle, you must cover all the dots.
It's easy to find a place to start. It's hard to find a place to finish.
To solve the puzzle, you need to place a spider and make it follow a straight line to another point. To solve the puzzle, you must cover all the dots but one with spiders. If the purple dots are numbered 1 to 8 clockwise from the top position, select 1 through 6, 4 through 1 and 6 through 4. So, if the purple dots...
No, we're starting from here.
Okay.
1,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8.
Okay.
Okay. Select 1 through 6. Or 1 and 6.
Yeah. So 1.
Which way should I go?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that goes to here.
I wonder if you will get the point of this.
Which way should I go now?
Go 1.
The points of this star are missing something.
7.
2, 6, 7.
Which way 4. Should I go now? There's something
2.
Missing. This star seems to have lost its sparkle. Which way should I go now?
5.
Which way should I go now?
8.
Which way should I go now?
3. 8.
Curses! There, yeah. Okay, upstairs. At the top, turn left.
I'm not going to the sink to get up there with the cameras.
No, those are one time only.
So I still don't get what the point that was. Because could have just gone upstairs and still made upstairs.
go to the end of the corridor and through the door into the toy room.
So I didn't even bother checking any other walkthroughs to see if they're all about the same or if it really mattered what order we did these in.
Give up?
Okay. Okay, so I'm probably just gonna have to cut a bunch of this out and just... get the solution. Well, no, there's no solution. It's just you do each column to the center one fits to what it's supposed to be, and then do the top and then the bottom, which I don't see how that matters. Whether you do the top or the bottom first, I don't.
Well, is there a way to get three of these in a row? Like, if I were to do... But I wonder, because see, I have two. If I get three in a row,
well, you'd have to do the top one.
Then that would be in a row.
Sun.
That would be in a row. That would be in a row.
Yeah. So do the top one until you get the sun. No, no, no. The top until you get the sun in that corner.
So they're all the same now.
Now flip it.
So now flip the rows.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not even guessing if this will work or not. But well, but now.
You're in the wrong order. Put it back to the thing and back.
Well, if I did back, it'd be this one.
Well, whatever it is, make it all the same again.
Yeah, yeah, do that a bunch of times. Well, or either
or just
side.
Keep going forward.
Yeah.
And then do the middle one until it matches the one to the left.
That's what I was doing.
No, no, the middle column.
So it matches the sun's?
Yeah, not the sun. Don't make it a sun. Make it the one that's next to the sun. Do that one and make it the one that's next to that one.
Which is that one.
And then do the middle columns, make it match the middle, and then you can do the bottom one.
There's just no guarantee that's gonna be.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we have a decent guarantee, we have a decent chance.
I'm pretty sure it'll work.
Because
if
it's working.
Those match, then those three will match, and then that means those three will match.
Yeah. Aha, oh, I'm a genius.
Yeah, you're a genius.
I started it.
So clearly the walkthrough is broken.
Ta-da! I'm a genius.
That's
okay, so
not cricket, is it?
Two or three walkthroughs that we found didn't really help us.
The trick was to get each column the same picture.
Dolls.
And line them
I
up.
I would stop. Keep this room, a room filled with dolls, locked. Unless, oh no, I know what this is. I know what these dolls are.
I want to be an art. I love my mommy. Where's my mommy? Where's
I know that voice. She lived next door to us. And Samantha, she got sick and, oh no, the
dolls!
Are the children! The children's spirits became these dolls! That was his deal. Stoff took the children, but not all of them, only a certain number, and...
That's it! A certain number!
What? What was that you just said?
For tonight, the children had to be collected. There must be one more child coming. The last guest.
No! No! He's here already! I've seen him! He ran away! Away! The others are learning about the boy. What must happen to him? What must be done?
We've got to find him and get him out!
Help me! No!
You look downstairs, and I'll look upstairs. We must move fast before the others.
Okay, right. So that was interesting. So if you follow the walkthroughs online, that should probably work eventually. But apparently what works faster is whatever we did at the end.
So start with the top row, but you gotta get each column the same picture. So the first column on the left, we made it all suns because that was the top corner of the picture.
Oh,
the second one we lined up with the sun, which would have been the second picture, and we got all that column the same pictures. Third column we lined up with the top, so the top row was set.
Then but all the pictures were the same.
And all the pictures were the same in each column, so they were all the suns next to the sun and next to that.
Oh.
Then we went to the middle row, and we just scrolled through those pictures until they lined up with the building. And then the bottom row, we scrolled through, or clicked through, until it lined up with the pathway.
Okay, so that was way easier than...
Yeah, so getting each column the same picture for that place of the top row.
Okay.
Yeah.
But assuming
so
that would... Well, assuming that would work every single time, if that was just a fluke for that random time that it worked.
Well, it could have been a fluke, but I thought it, and it happened, so...
Okay.
So I'm a genius.
Okay, I'm gonna go with that. Okay, now we're to.
Blocks puzzle. Yeah, see the other walkthrough that we had told me where to go. This one doesn't tell me where to go.
No, so just go back one or two tabs over or something.
Alright, so we did coins, we did spider, we did that, we did picture flip. Okay. Walk forward and go through the tiny door in the doll's house. Because why not?
So we've looked through a couple of different walkthroughs now, but now we're back to the original one just because it kind of explains where to go.
This one gives directions the other, like on where to walk. This one, the other one gives directions on how to solve.
Yeah.
Approach the chest of drawers to see a grid of 9 blocks. Click at the bottom of column 1. Oh, so those drawers.
So some of these are a little off, because trying to find where to turn doesn't, when you put your mouse in that location, it doesn't pull up exactly what you're supposed to do. It's like the mouse is here, it flashed for a second, then it went away. So the whole thing is just a little bit off for some reason. I'm not quite sure why.
3 little words. That's all it takes.
Get boy Tad?
Yep. Get boy Tad.
So it's backwards.
Yeah. So click at the bottom of column 1, top of column... Okay. Yeah. Wait, what?
Oh. So if you use these little glasses, it shows you where you can click. It's all the eyeballs. No. So bottom of...
So click at the bottom of column 1.
Okay.
Top of column 3.
Well, it should be as easy as ABC.
Oh, so that moves the letters around. Okay.
Yeah. Top of column 3.
Look, it's a magic spell puzzle.
So that was interesting that it started out all backwards, but you could read it where it said, get boy Tad.
That's interesting.
And I think that was the solution, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right?
Anyway, so bottom of the first column, top of the second. Top of the third column.
Yeah, the bottom of the first column, top of column three.
Okay.
Right of row one.
Right
of row
one.
I used to have blocks just like this when I was a child. The memory seems so clear now.
Okay. Left of row three.
Left of row. Good thing it's not eat.
Close enough. Bottom of column one.
Bottom of column one.
Top of column three. Right of row one. And then left.
Oh, I'm getting bored.
Left of row three. They're basically just rotating them.
Yeah.
There.
What's that weird kid that's been running around? No, I mean, I guess he's not weird, but the kid that's been running around.
No, I said that's not the kid.
Damn.
Oh.
The little kid that's been running around through the game so far is Tad.
Yeah, I thought you meant the picture of that guy was.
Oh.
That one was there.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, I'm trying to read directions, man. Come on. Come on, man. Turn around and leave the doll's house. You will leave the toy room. Interesting.
That leaves the entire room?
Yeah.
Okay.
Turn right, enter the room where you completed the coins puzzle earlier. View the cutscene on the left of this room. And you will go through the door into the chapel. So,
the cutscene on the left of the room. A secret room. This is the puzzle that Stoff set out. And I solved it.
Just walk right
in. See, from what I remember when I was playing it, it was just, you'd kind of just pick a room and I'd go to it and find whatever I could in that room and just solve puzzles, so...
Well, that's probably what you can do. I don't think you
can. I know, that's what I'm trying to figure out, why these walkthroughs are going through a certain order, but...
Well, the magic teleporting through the sink and the fireplace.
Yeah, because that's completely random. But, like, some of the other ones just show, like, certain puzzles that you can solve, so...
Yeah. So, look at the floor. Admire the floor.
Using only what you see, can you get from A to B?
Yeah, that makes sense. Off of the room. Okay.
So that must be A. That must be B.
So that's one, that's an IP. So from one, do two. Right there.
So this is one.
Step on the tiles in the floor in order, in the order above. So, yeah, start with one.
Oh.
Go two.
There's more to these markings.
Three is the tan
than
one.
Meets the eye.
That right there. Well, that is three.
Is there a pattern to this?
And then four is the other tan one.
It's as
five
easy as one, two, three.
Six is right above it. Seven is next to it. Eight is next to that. Nine is purple. Ten is blue. 11 is blue. 12 is blue.
This one?
Yep. I see.
Do go to 11.
Yeah, do that one.
This
The tan one. Then do the blue one. Then the purple one. That one. Then blue. Brown. Purple. Blue.
This one?
Yep. Brown. And then the red one.
His walkthroughs
on. Careful you don't slip and fall.
Why is there a hole? So we just go to the first floor.
Why is there
right?
a chapel on the second floor of a house?
It's a mansion. Wouldn't it just go to the first floor?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now forward.
Walk forward to the altar, then go right through a door into the laboratory.
Now the sacrifice must come from you. It must be brought to me. Alive. A final.
Holding it by the blade. Okay. Yeah, just leave the baby inside right here.
That's odd.
So
to the
go
right.
right for a door into the laboratory. Dexter's laboratory. Oh my gosh.
Sorry.
View the cutscene at the workbench.
I still remember this.
This? This! Yes, this is it! Not magic! This is stuff secret! Some demented science! I have this day discovered a way to communicate. I want a power! Real magic, if it existed! Not this! Not her!
They die, but not really. Go over to the microscope and examine it.
There's another cutscene.
It doesn't say watch it yet.
The micro to the what?
Microscope.
I'm assuming it's back there.
I don't know where. Oh yeah,
oh,
that
right
there.
There.
It's
hard
to hard
see.
To see. Yeah. Oh yeah, stop fucking me. Examine it. This game pits you against AI in a game similar to Reversi. You must end up with more blue pieces on the board than green to win.
Where do I go? To the gate.
That? Hey, we're in the library magically. Yeah. On the first floor.
Turn around and go through the gate to the library. Turn around and go through the door to the lobby. And then turn right and go through the double doors into the music room.
Ooh. Right here?
Yeah. I thought that looked a little different. So I remember the thing doing the little, like, go this way, go this way. Oh, okay, watch the cutscene at the piano. And I'll examine the piano.
I got this piano for a song.
Repeat the sequence of notes that is played.
Oh, I missed it already.
I remember when I used to play Follow the Leader.
I don't know what number drop is, so this is not good.
challenge.
all the king's horses, and all the king's men.
Okay, so you just need to return all the squares of the portrait back to normal by clicking on the parts of the picture.
Is there...
No.
So, like...
So Staff has an ego, too. But somehow I get the impression he's not quite all there.
Parts of the painting change. When one of the corner squares is clicked, three squares adjacent to it shape. And the shape of a square flip from one picture to the next. Oh, I see the pattern. Okay.
That's funny. Stoff's falling apart, and I'm putting him back together again.
So the painting changes from a human Stoff to a red devil to a green demon and back to normal. Solution. So as the parts of the painting are random at the start, there's no set solution to the problem.
This puzzle reminds me of the coffins, but Stoff seems to be in more of a state than ever.
To fix the center cell without affecting the others, click on the corner cell twice, followed by the opposite corner twice, blah, blah, blah. Try to get the parts of the painting into a symmetrical layout, as this makes it easier to change them all. But all of them keep saying there's no solution.
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
I don't know how to do this one.
So it says from normal to red devil to green demon and then back to normal.
Right. And I got it down to one, but I didn't know how to get rid of the one.
Oh, I see what it means. So if it's normal, you click on it, it turns red. Click on it again, it turns green.
Turns green.
Okay.
And then click on it again, and it goes normal.
Okay. Yeah, I remember this one, but I don't... It's probably just a matter of...
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this. Solve this.
If the opposite left and right cells in the middle row are matched, so it doesn't seem to be a solution.
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this. Be dead by the time you solve this.
So this walkthrough goes through a completely different order.
We'll all be dead by the time we solve this.
Yeah, so these ones that go for that maze thing, they all...
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
So all these other walkthroughs with the maze all do the same thing. They get down to number 9 and then they turn. So I don't know why that was...
I don't know.
Go to the dead end and then turn around. And some of these other ones have solutions, like the crypt ones. Oh, and here's one that says 2 kitchen, quarter, second floor, library.
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
All the doors that we saw, those 3 doors. What's your deal?
That's me when I try to sleep. Oh, I'm gonna throw up if I keep sneezing. Is that normal?
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
We didn't do this cutscene. We had the person on the table thing. What's your deal? So as I'm looking through some of these other walkthroughs...
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
Clearly I can't talk, because between you sneezing and him talking... Again, so these other walkthroughs don't all
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
So these other walkthroughs don't all go in the same order. They seem to jump around a little bit.
So there's no real, like, order to them?
Doesn't seem to be.
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
And like this one with the picture puzzle, it has it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then 8 through.
Why? Oh, wait. Oh, like what the...
Well, I guess.
I like my method.
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
Well, you created it.
So this one says they can't give a solution to the picture because it's random to start with. But it says they suggest use the puzzle book in the library to solve this one for you. Oh yeah, now I remember. So the puzzle book in the library lets you solve puzzles. So if you just can't get it figured out...
We'll all be dead by the time you solve this.
You go to the puzzle book in the library...
Found again!
So there's this puzzle book in the library.
Jurassic Park.
Okay.
So there's a puzzle book in the library that would give us clues.
This is going to be interesting daily because I'm going to be constantly cutting out everything.
It's going to say, so to finish this.
Yeah.
What's next, mister?
Okay, well, stop talking.
I did.
So, I completely forgot about this, but there's a puzzle book in the library that if you can't solve a puzzle, you go straight to the puzzle book, and then it says that it is solved. So, basically, it finishes it for you. Hint about the puzzle you're working on. Oh, so you go to the puzzle book, it gives you a hint on how to solve the puzzle that you're working on, and then you get sent back to where you were, so it automatically sends you back there. And then if you come back, it basically gives you more hints.
Is that what the glasses are for, or is it given to you as you're doing it?
No, so if you're on a puzzle and you can't solve it, you go to the puzzle book, it'll give you a hint on how to solve the puzzle. And it looks like you can do that a couple times, and then I think after the third time, it looks like it just solves it for you.
So far, we've been able to figure them all out.
Yeah. So if you can't figure out a puzzle, you go to the puzzle book, it gives you a hint, it sends you back to that puzzle. You still can't get it, you go back and get another hint. But the third time you go to the puzzle book, it'll just solve it for you. So that's interesting. So I didn't need to find a solution for that. You solved that one.
I got it. I figured out the pattern. Well, it wasn't a pattern, but I figured out what one push to get to turn how I wanted him to eventually.
So it looks like there's only two final puzzles left.
Okay, where do we go?
Knives and windows. So, turn right again and go through the painting.
This one?
Return to the music room.
Well, that's handy.
Click the plant. Turn into Margo. Climb up the plant into the bedroom.
Jack and the Beanstalk.
Why can't we just use the stairs?
I don't know. I mean, it's cool that they got all these little warp things throughout the whole thing, but...
Like, would you not be able to access this... Yeah, we can access this room.
Yeah. Oh, no. So, click on the plant, and I open the bedroom. Turn around and leave the room.
Well, that was handy.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for bringing me here.
Then approach the door straight ahead. A little that door.
Is this the toy room? No. Oh. Alright. Well, let's even look in. Do I go in?
No. You need to move the knives from one point to another, jumping over other knives to remove them. Click on the knives at position, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so it goes the very top point is 1, and then the far left is 2, 3, 4, 5.
Wait. 1, 2, 3. This is 3?
Nope. It goes across.
Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And then 6 is right there. 7 is straight across. 8 is in the middle.
8.
And then 9, and then 10.
9, 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
5, 6, 7. Man, you're gonna help me. Okay.
Clearly. Okay, so do position 7 first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
7.
Nope. Six is on the left.
Seven.
So click on seven. So that jumped to the top and it removed that one. Okay. So click on position two, which is the top left.
This one?
Yep. That will jump that one and remove that one. Then eight, which is in the center at the bottom. Right
that
there.
One?
And then five, which is the, yep, that one. So I remember doing this puzzle too, so I must have gotten all the way to the end. And then number one, which is the very top. Which is funny because this picture looks like the Boy Witch thing going on.
Oh, that's nice. Not.
So you did one, so then two.
This one?
Yep. And then nine, and then ten.
Nine?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Great move.
That was a compliment. That was not normal. That's a scary door. Okay, next.
Okay. Go through this door and upstairs into the attic.
Ooh.
Creepy attic.
We're like running. We're excited.
Examine the model building on the right.
This one?
Yes.
I guess that's the
only
one.
The goal is to reach the top of the building by going from
consider this game
one window to the next.
The
oh dear.
House.
This is trickier than it looks.
So the goal is to reach the top of the building by going from one window to the next. Each type of window allows you to move only in one direction, which you set the first time you click after selecting that type of window. Start at window 6 from the left, then go... Okay, so the whole pet thing. So... Start at window 6.
So, like, counting?
From the left.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I'm guessing that's what that means. Okay.
So click it.
Start at window 6 from the left, then go up. Don't click it, but go up. Right. Left. Click that one. Okay, so then start at window 6 from the left, then go up. Okay, so click on that one. Right. Click on that one. Left.
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
Next level.
So that was the pattern. Start at window 6. Hold on. I'm just repeating the first one. Start at window 6 from left, go up, right, left, and then down. That moves you up to the top level, so select window 3 on the next level.
From the left again?
Doesn't say. Select window 3 on the next level. Then window 2 on the top level, go through the far door to complete the game. So select window 3.
This one or this one?
I don't know. I would say that one probably.
How in the world does this make sense?
Have the pain. patience to go any further.
And the fact that you just walk into the attic and be like, oh, that looks like a puzzle thing, I'll figure that out. What in the world? Okay. Then window 2 on the top level, so that's window 2.
Can I click it? What's that stuff there?
No!
Alright, now anybody would know that.
Help me, someone, please, help me.
Get up.
I can't.
Run away.
I can't. I looked over here and something happened. Oh, someone, please help me.
Aha! Come here, you little one. One lost puzzle.
One more puzzle?
So let's go for the far door to complete the game.
Right there?
Yeah.
Let me go! It's okay, darling. You know I won't hurt you. Just come upstairs.
It hasn't happened yet.
Let me! No! Let me!
I've been here before. I've seen all this over and over.
Help me! Someone, please!
Tried to help. Tried to help myself. Always failing.
You little brat!
That's a mirror. I need to go.
Yeah, so turn, go through the door.
The smell. I can't breathe.
Yeah, but that's you.
But he just said you saved me.
Right, so basically what it sounds like is...
We're Tad? We saved Tad?
Right, so this event happened, but then you came through as an invisible guest.
Told you we were a ghost.
So yeah, so we came through, solved all the puzzles, and changed the history of it. Yes.
Told you we were ghosts. No other people can go through things.
So I remember all this. I did actually finish this game.
48 years of living.
So.
An angel in disguise. 48 years of loving. Smiling with my eyes.
Rise and dance upon the grave.
Okay, so the story is interesting. Game begins with a flashback to 1935. The Drifter stuff kills a woman, kills a curse. You can see how that's beginning. In the game's present, the narrator, which is you, named Ego, awakens in the mansion. The mansion is deserted, but as you explore it, you have ghostly visions of the events of the past. Visions take place on a night sometime after the deaths of the children. Those six guests were invited to the mansion, explained by people. They discover a number of puzzles that give them instructions. They learn that Stomp wanted them to bring a seventh uninvited guest, a boy named Tad, who entered the house all day. The guests debate on what to having made a pact with the evil forces that gave him visions of the children, gave him his visions and killed the children. Stoff has transformed into a horrific creature. He needs Tad's soul to complete the pact. Stoff kills Julia and entangles Tad with his weird tongue. Ego realizes that he is the spirit of Tad, witnessing the events that night over and over. But previously unable to help, the house has been in purgatory. Ego finds that he can now intervene and help Tad escape. He's unable to capture the child and gets pulled underground. Okay, so that makes sense now. So, the events happened way back in 1935. You show up there, and you don't know who you are, or why you're there, or what you are, but you're the ghost of Tad. You go through and solve all the puzzles, and because you solved the puzzles, you saved yourself from getting killed back
in 1935. Told you we were ghosts. I knew it.
So, interesting. And I never looked into the story, so I guess I didn't know what the exact story was, I guess, back then when I went through it. But I remember all that now that I've gone through it. So I did actually finish this game. And then I did start the 11th hour, but I know I didn't get through that one, because I know that one was a lot longer. Apparently there's a few other sequels. There's the 11th Hour, the 7th Guest 3, the Collector, the 13th Doll, 7th Guest, the Board Game, and then the 25th Anniversary Edition, which is this version. Okay, so that took a lot longer than I thought it would take. But that is a pretty clear walkthrough. Like I said, we used a couple of different walkthroughs online, which they didn't all quite work out. Some of the beginning ones are fairly easy to go through, but as we got to the other puzzles, we had to switch and find some different walkthroughs to help explain it a little better and or find a solution.
A few we had to do on our own.
Yeah, and a few we had to do on our own. A few we had to find better solutions. Just some of the walkthroughs explained it a little better, but alright, well, thanks for watching.
Bye.